Rajinikanth to start his political party in January. A formal announcement on Rajinikanth's political ambitions is going to now be made on the 31st of December. So remember, this is an extremely interesting development that has taken place. There are going to be elections in Tamil Nadu in 2021. Rajinikanth is going to be making his political debut, or rather announcing his plans for his much-awaited political debut, if I can call it that, in January 2021. There is likely to be that mega announcement on the 31st of December. Sam Daniel joins us with the very latest. Sam, you know, many would say finally.
That's right. It ends almost 2 decades of suspense in that sense, Rashika. Even in the month of October, there were suggestions, indications that he may not make that political plunge, citing health reasons. But things have changed after he met his district secretaries on Monday, after which, in a brief press interaction, he had said he would announce it as early as possible, and that his secretaries have decided to abide by whatever decision he would take, and that they both had exchanged lots of information. In his brief tweet this morning, he has also hashtagged, "It's now or never. We will change, and we will change it completely." And he also says in January he would launch his party. The announcements would be made on the 31st of December. And he says, "We will surely win assembly polls with people's support and give honest, transparent, corruption-free, spiritual politics without any caste or creed. A wonder and miracle will definitely happen." That's what Rajinikanth says. And this, at the moment at least, rules out... still, the big question, of course, would be whether he would fight it alone or he would... fight in alliance with any other parties. That's the big question. But hopefully there should be some clarity in January whenever he makes that announcement. And fans are extremely happy. I spoke to a few of them and they said they very much expected this. One young fan said, "Our Thalaivar will never cheat on people. He takes his own time," but he said he was very hopeful of a positive decision by Rajinikanth. And earlier in the month of October, he had cited doctors' concerns, especially on his health condition after his renal transplant in the year 2016, saying that in the midst of pandemic, it may not be advisable to go on an open campaign across the state, and that was a major concern. He confirmed those leaked reports, as many call it, saying as far as the health is concerned, health advisory is concerned, whatever you see in that report is correct. And many would say in the year 1996, Rajinikanth's singular statement that even God cannot save Tamil Nadu if Jayalalitha was re-elected, that paved way for the DMK-TMC combined to win elections. The DMK came to power, and his fans point out that for criticism that this could be too late, Rajini is starting late when other parties have actually kick-started their campaign in Tamil Nadu.
Sam, that actually brings me to my next important question of the timing.
During that time, in the year 1996, Rajinikanth's singular statement helped the DMK-TMC combine to win elections in just 2 weeks' time. That's the power of the reach of his words, they say. And this time too, they say he has a full 5 months, even from January. And that should be more than enough, they say. But there are many others who look at this differently, saying that Tamil Nadu for quite some time has stopped the culture of electing film stars as leaders. They point out how leaders like Vijay Ganth, leaders like Sivaji Ganesan, leaders like Sarath Kumar have not made big in Tamil Nadu politics, and that culture, that era is gone. And they say even Kamal Hassan has made only limited success in that sense. But Kamal Hassan's party points out that over the last the last Lok Sabha elections, they managed to get
Sam,
up to 4%.
But, you know, if I can just interrupt you there and ask you about, you know, how crucial this timing is. And, you know, while that hashtag "it's now or never" is very interesting, the question really is it too late Given the fact that assembly elections in Tamil Nadu are scheduled to take place between April and May of 2021, if I'm not wrong. So is Rajnikant's political foray being announced on the 31st of December? Is it going to be too late for him to start campaigning on the ground? Is this going to be an independent political foray? Is he likely to join forces with another political party? What is it that you're picking up? In terms of what exactly are his plans and the timing of those plans?
Rishika, if you look at this in a conventional way, yes, this could appear like a very belated attempt or announcement because he doesn't have the grassroots set up like a political party to reach out at the level of booth committee workers. But his fans give a different picture. They say for quite some time, his fan clubs have been working on the ground with a very well-established structure going all up to the grassroots level. And they've been engaging with people, with communities over the last several years. And they don't compare Rajnikant with the traditional or conventional politicians. They say he's a superstar. People know him very well already. And he doesn't have to strain himself in that sense to go and reach out to every nook and corner. And they say it's very easy for Rajnikant to ignite that kind of a spark, ignite that kind of a wave, as one fan called it, and it will be very simple for them. So they're very hopeful that his charisma, his superstardom will actually help him in that sense. And time, although it looks very short at the moment, 5 months time, they say he will be able to break that barrier and make waves in that sense politically, Rishika.